We, IBM, we are a 105-year-old startup, and needless to say, during that 105 years, we have had to make a lot of changes along the way. Every competitor we've ever had has slowly faded off into the side, and we've kept on, and we're in the middle of a new change, and the new change is cloud. It is the centerpiece of what we're doing. Bluemix, our platform as a service, is the centerpiece of our cloud strategy. The coolest part about Bluemix is that everything I've seen tonight, everything, so many of the things I've seen tonight, they can do out here, you can do out here. Bluemix is a place for developers to go to deploy applications. Everyone here, and I'll bring up the URL again in a little while, everyone here has access to Bluemix. All you have to do is go and sign up and you can use it freely. I'll bring up the URL again at the end. When you go to Bluemix and log in, you get presented with a group of different solutions that you can use. In this case, if I want to build out an iOS application, I want to choose an iOS app, and it lets me choose some mobile security, choose my database, choose some push notification for mobile apps. I can do the same thing with our Watson services. I can choose the Watson services as a solution bundle. I can do it with Internet of Things. I'll show you some of that in just a moment. You can choose those services, but since there are geeks and geekstresses in the room, I'll explain it in a way that's a lot easier for you, because you can understand it. You can go and choose the runtime or framework that you want to use. In this case, if I wanted to use something with, let's say, Node, somebody was talking about Node recently, you pick an instance of Node and you go off and run. Then you say, hey, I want a database, or I want a Watson service, or I want a mobile service. You choose those, and now they are linked with your application. They're actually bound to the app. So let's pick Node here. If I said I want to create a application with Node, it says, what do you want to create your application? I'll give it a name of NYTM, and off it goes. And when I get done, nytm.mybluemix.net will be live and on the web. The easiest way to explain how this works to more technical people like yourselves is I'll push an app. Bluemix is based on Cloud Foundry. I am logged into Bluemix right now. And, can you give me a name, just a word, whatever, anything? Pickle. Okay, as long as I can spell P-I-C-K-L-E, let's go with that. I'm going to push an application right now up into Bluemix. So Bluemix is based on Cloud Foundry. It's running on, we've got 40 data centers around the world. We bought a company called SoftLayer. Cloud Foundry runs there. It's your cloud broker. Yeah, it's easy. We just buy them. So it's your cloud broker, right? It's pretty cool when you can do that. And they're huge. They got their own fiber optics, that kind of thing. Cloud Foundry is running on top of there. So when I just went to Cloud Foundry, CF, push from my hard disk, I'm pushing up an application my friend Ryan wrote. Sunday morning, I'm at the club, I'm working out. Ryan created a chat application, which I would love for you to hook into your emoji stuff, which is very cool, by the way. Ryan created a chat app, and I said, hey, Ryan, you created a chat app, which I can simply push up into Bluemix. Your code that's on my hard disk, 238K, you might have noticed, tells Bluemix in the manifest, I need an instance of Node, and I need an instance of Redis. And when you get done, I want you to fire up that application that Ryan wrote. By the way, it took him 1.5 days to write. He pushes it up into Bluemix, it stages that instance of Node, and it's off and running. I called him, actually I sent him a note from the health club, and I said, hey, how about if we take that and we hook it into my friend Brian's Internet of Things application that he created? And so Brian created this IoT application. It took, I think he said 17 minutes to hook it into this application that I'm starting right here. It's staging on our servers, and there is that instance of that application. You can see it staging, and it's up and it's running in just a moment. While it's doing that, let me go over and I'll pull up another dashboard. I created a similar one here. It's called NYTM Chat. And so when I launch it, there's the application that's off and running. In fact, let's go back over here and see Pickle. Pickle is still staging right now. Things are slow in the evenings. I'll go back over here And when I launch this, I am launching that chat application right now, and it is out. Anybody that goes to nytmchat.mybluemix.net around the world, we're into a chat application. I'll give myself a name here, DB. It says it's all quiet. I ask a gentleman over here if he could hook into he's all hail Ram Dam. Okay, so anybody that goes out there and chats, you can chat. I just rolled out an application, and I'm sure that Pickle is probably launched up here now too. I just rolled out an application. Here it is. There's Pickle, and it's rolled out, and anybody around the world can use it now. That's pretty incredible. So I said to Ryan, can you hook this into the Internet of Things application? My friend has a Sphero. So, I named my ball Kevin, my Sphero, Kevin Bacon. It's my 6 degrees of separation. Could you please make Kevin Bacon turn blue? How's that? So we say, oop, Kevin Bacon turned yellow. Kevin Bacon turned blue. And let's roll it out here. Let's make Kevin Bacon dance. And so Kevin Bacon dances. Yeah, so that is a Internet of Things application that we deployed live out on the web. It's out available for anybody to use. Kevin Bacon can turn red, yellow, blue, and dance. There's my 6 degrees of separation. The cool part about all of this, we can run servers elsewhere. So what? We've done it before. We can use different databases and protocols and schemas. So what? We've done it before. The fact that you, Ram Dam, any of you can go here for free, log in, build an application, say, hey, this application rocks. Let's go over and see how much this thing costs if we want to roll it out more. Sure. You want to roll out 100 instances? The backbone of this can handle 100 million transactions a second. It's our MQ series. So if you want to start automating all of the automobiles in New York City with Arduino devices, the same Internet of Things application can do that. To me, though, the most exciting thing is that you all can take your innovations and go here. It is no longer just for big companies. You get your idea, your big idea, you put it out here. If it doesn't work, hit delete. You paid nothing. Low risk. If you hit it out of the park, scale it up and take it to the masses. Thank you all very much.